When you shook the hands of Will, what does he mean to your team? And that was a pretty impressive kick and a pretty impressive time.
Yeah, definitely. But to have a kicker like we have in Will, you know, it gives us so much confidence. When we were charged.
One timeout. Are you rattled at all? What are you thinking when you get the ball? You did it in the Iron Bowl. You're thinking, I got to go down and do this again, or what's running through your head?
That's where we love to be at. You know, we know what it takes. You know, we have no wavering. I feel confident in those position in that position as a unit. We do. You know, we all embrace that challenge, but we know what it means. You know, when it's time for us to step up, and, you know, in those crunch time moments, that's what we're made for.
Tell me about that scramble touchdown that you had. You kind of squatted down, ran to the left. You found. I think Jameer.
You know, it was good coverage. They dropped back plate coverage. We had an empty on and tried to extend the play. Jameer did a great job breaking off of his route. Really instinctual play. He had a hitch out there, came back and broke across the face, saw it last minute, and we were able to score in a really timely moment.
What do you think led to the penalties throughout the game for you guys?
I think it's just a lack of execution. It's most of them, I feel like for us, were self-inflicted. So we have to make sure we clean that up. Obviously, watching film, we have better practices, things like that. I think that's stuff that we're going to definitely have to improve on and keep working on going forward. But majority of them were self-inflicted. So internally, we have to practice that, work on that, make that a point of emphasis.
At times, it seems like Will Anderson just doesn't make mistakes. On a day where he does make a few mental errors, how big is it for you guys to pick him up? And what are you guys thinking during those times?
That's the thing with us. We all have each other's back. Nobody's perfect. And, even when there are, whatever mistakes that everyone makes, we all rally around each other. And then, we still, regardless of what's happened earlier in the game, we know late in the game that Will's always going to come up big for us. We know what he means for us, not just on the field and with the stats, but just as a leader. So even when, even if it may not show up in the stat sheet, what he means for us as a defense, as a team, is immeasurable. So
before the fourth quarter, you guys had five straight three and out. What was going on offensively? Was there frustration setting?
A lack of execution. First and foremost, that starts on me. I have to make sure that we're all executing better. We're getting the right people. We're executing the pass game, all that. So first and foremost, that falls on my shoulders. We have to do a better job executing. And then, as far as you said with any sort of doubt or frustration, I don't think we had any frustration. We're obviously competitors. When we don't have success, it's not the ideal. It's not the ideal scenario. But we understand through what Coach Saban has taught us, what OB and everyone the building teaches us is, we got to play the next play. Coach Saban's saying that all the time. So we go back to the sideline. Obviously, no one's happy. We don't want to not have success, but it's not a frustration thing. We go back to the sideline. We analyze what we did wrong, what we didn't do, how we didn't execute. We move on to the next play.
Bryce, in the last drive, you had that sack. You kind of escaped from that sack by squatting down and they took off running. Can you walk us through that play?
I couldn't tell you. There's someone hot up the edge. That's my fault. I have to make sure we slide our protection to there. Didn't get us in the right protection, so that's on me. We shouldn't have had to deal with that, but. It was just instinct. Obviously, it was a big moment, big play. I knew I couldn't, I couldn't get sacked, couldn't afford to go down. So I was just trying to do whatever it took to keep the chains moving and keep the drive alive.
Two more questions.
Will said this one of the toughest games he's been in. Do you feel that same way, or how do you feel about it?
Yeah, I mean, this was definitely a tough one. That was a great team we went against, a really tough environment. Obviously, you look at the score, came down to the last second field goal with 10, 15 seconds left. So, obviously this is one of the tougher ones we've been in. There's a lot of stuff that we wish we executed better, a lot of ways we can improve. But I think in the end, when you get tested like this, you put in these positions, you learn about yourself as a team, you grow as a team. So, we want to make sure that we're improving on what we didn't do as well. But at the end of the day, there's a blessing in us being able to win a close one like this.
How tough was that pass rush? Did that kind of take you guys by surprise?
I don't think by surprise, but they have great players over there. We knew that coming in, and throughout the game they had great players on the defensive line. They work really hard. They look good on film. They look good today. So we want to execute, be a little bit cleaner. But at the end of the day, when the defensive line has success, it's not the O line. A lot of this stuff I have to do a better job of making sure we're going to the right people, making sure we're sliding to where we have the right help, right gaps, making sure me and the backs are communicating. I'm making sure they know where to go. So a lot of that rests on me as well.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you.